Now let us discuss about some more special methods. Okay, so already we have discussed three special methods, init, string and representation methods we have discussed, right? Apart from this, what are all the other special methods available in Python, okay, in object-oriented programming, that we will just discuss now. Okay, just like an overview I will give here, so that I want you to try some programs based on this. Okay, so we have the representation method. We know that this function is called when the value of the object is displayed in the Python shell. Okay, so when you want to see the value of the particular object, then you can just call this representation method. Okay, then the second method is string method. So this method will be holding the string values, and using the print function, within the print function, the object will be printed. Okay, then it will just print the value, okay, value of the string which is available in the string method. Then we have another method called comparison. This method overrides the behavior of double equals to operator for comparing the objects of the class. Okay, then this method will just have a template for comparison, okay, whether it is equal to. Okay, the comparison will be verified if you call this particular method. Okay, and then length method. This method retrieves the length of the object. Okay, and we have a del method. It deletes the object, which means it just behaves like a destructor function. Okay, so it is a destructor function. It deletes the object which is created. Right, so why we are going for this delete method or destructor? See, where we know that when we have discussed about the object concept, there itself we have discussed, whenever the class has been created, the memory will not be allocated for the variables. Am I right? When the object is initiated, at the time only the memory will be allocated for each and every variable of the class. Right? So similarly, after executing the program, at the end, if you use this delete method and if you delete the object, then whatever memory which is allocated will be deleted. Okay, otherwise those memory allocated will remain, right? So to delete that, we can go for the delete method. So hence we are calling this as destructor. Okay, it deletes automatically, hence we are calling them as destructor. Okay, then this init method is a constructor method. This we know. Okay, when the object is created, automatically the method will be called. Okay, so apart from this, we have some more arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operation, for arithmetic operations, we have some methods. So we have add method, just to add the two variables, subtract, multiplication, and for division, this will result in quotient value. And floor division we have, okay, so this will give you truncated division. Okay, and then we have mod operation. So these are all some of the arithmetic operations for which we are having the inbuilt methods. Right, then apart from that, comparison purpose, we have some more methods, comparison operators, LT, which is less than, okay, so this will check A less than B, okay, and then GT greater than, LE less than or equal to, GE greater than or equal to, EQ double equals to, NE not equals to, right, so these are all the methods, special methods available for comparison operator purpose. Okay. Then we have Boolean operators. So the Boolean operators, we have double asterisk. So we know that in Python, whenever we are going to use double asterisk, right, the meaning is A to the power B. Am I right? So it is a power. So how it is represented? It is represented like self comma other. Okay, so I will tell you one program. So at the end of this session, I'll show you one program which executes some operators. I will just show you demo so that you just try for all the other operators. Okay, so and for right shift. Okay, so this symbol represents right shift, right? So for right shift, we have R shift, self comma, other. And for left shift, it is L shift. And ampersand is AND. And this represents R, and for this gap represents XOR. Okay. Then we have some of the in place operators. So So the shorthand operator we have discussed, right? So whenever you want to do just like this, a equals to a plus 1. Okay, this we can write just like this also, a plus equals to 1. So the expanded form of this a plus equals to 1 is just like this, a equals to a plus 1. Okay, in place operator, right? So if we represent just like this, it is called as in place operator. So minus equals to, okay, which is in place subtraction, plus equals to, which performs in place addition, in place multiplication, just like the arithmetic operation whatever we have discussed previously. Okay, so the same operation we are going to do with in place. Hence we have I division, I floor division, I mod, I power, I right shift, left shift, and or XOR. Okay, so these are all the in place operators what we have here. Okay, so let me just show you some demo example here, and the same thing we will, I will show you demo. Okay, I'll explain the example here, then we will discuss the demo. So just see, I have created a class add. Okay, so I have created a class add, or maybe what you can do, you can create the class as arithmetic. Okay, because all the arithmetic operations we are going to perform here using the special method, so that you can understand the syntax for special method. Right, so I have a class and I'm creating the constructor here. Okay, so we know that the init method is the constructor, right? So I'm creating the constructor here. So init self comma b, so it has one parameter, hence it is a parameterized constructor. Okay, then self dot b is equal to b. Okay, so the constructor part is finished up to this. So one variable I have passed using the constructor. Okay, next I am going to use the special method add. Okay, the syntax for using this particular method is def double underscore add double underscore self comma other. Okay, so one parameter we have to pass here, okay, which is other, right? So in return statement I am just giving self dot b plus other dot b. Just remember this particular thing I am just calling as self dot b. Okay, plus other dot b, I'm just accessing the second variable. Okay, then similarly, see, this is for performing addition, then this is for performing subtraction. Okay, here it is for division, here it is for truncation division, and this is for truncation division, normal division, multiplication. Okay, you just see the object creation part. Object 1 is equals to add of 10. One object I have created. For second object, I am passing the second value. Okay. So what happens whenever the object has been created, automatically the constructor will be initiated. For the first object, the value 10 has been assigned here. Right. For the second object, the value 20 has been assigned. Right. So automatically the constructor has been invoked here. Okay. Then what happens? You just see here, within each and every method, the corresponding operators we are using. Okay, and I'm not going to call these methods. So the rule for special methods are, these methods will not be called. Am I right? So these methods will never be called. It may be any type of special methods. The special methods will not be called using the object. Okay, instead, you just see here, in the first print statement, I have object 1 plus object 2. Right, so whenever it sees this plus operator, okay, automatically it will just execute this particular function. Okay, this particular special method will be executed automatically. Similarly, when it finds subtraction, this particular method will be executed. Whenever it has multiplication, this multiplication method will be accessed. Right, so similarly for normal division, true division method, for double slash floor division, okay, truncation method will be accessed, right? So hence the output for this program will be first addition 10 plus 20, which is 30, 10 minus 20, the second output is minus 10, and the third print statement has 10 into 20, hence it is 200, then 10 divided by 20, it is 0.5, okay, because this true division will just give you only the quotient part. Okay, and the truncation division will give you only the rounded values. Okay, see, in 0.5, the rounded value was 0. Right, so hence it is giving 0 as the output here. Okay, so just remember, this is the reason why I have just shown you the operators and the corresponding methods. Okay, so within this method, we have to check for this particular operation. And whenever we are going to call, we are going to invoke the special method just by using their operator. Okay, so I hope this example is clear. Let me explain the program for this. Okay, so here you just see this program I have written for the special methods. Okay, so the same program which we have seen just now. Okay, so I have a class. Let me just change the name of the class as arithmetic. Okay, and I have a constructor, and I have add method, subtract, multiplication, full division, correlation. Right? So if I execute, okay. Sorry, so I have changed the class name, right? So it should be changed as arithmetic. Right? So now if I execute, you can see the values. Okay, so just remember all these things. Okay, so all these methods, whatever I have used here, are all the special methods. So like this, just now I have shown you different methods, right? All those methods you can try writing the programs.